God sent Strike back in this Swedish affair. There was a whole lot of emotions. There was a lot of one-on-one action. Schneider had to do it. But in the end, we do see God sent emerge victorious in that second map. And there is a slightly smunk? Let me try again. I mixed smug and dunk. Let me try again.
Words are hard.
There's a slightly smug Duncan Thorin Shields beside me, as he was the only one expecting to see something from Godsent over on trainers. It would be rude not to start with the main man himself. You saw Godsent eventually edging it. Surely not by that in that way, though. So unbelievably close. And in the end, NIP making a few mistakes.
I mean, the thing is, like I said, the reason why I actually thought Train was a dangerous pick for the guys from Godsent is it's true. It's in theory not a good map for NIP. But NIP have shown us now three times in a row in best of three series that when they get on the CT side of this map, they make clutch plays. They make really good decisions when they're in 2v2s, 3v3s. And they're getting a lot of these clutch rounds going their way. Now, what was good about Godsent in the past times they played this map was the T side looked good. And actually, throughout the whole tournament, that's where their strengths really lied. So I thought, again, they had some good T side. Obviously, side was what allowed them to win in overtime here, so this was the real decider to me, because they could have crumbled here. NIP could have taken them, it could have been in two maps. Now we're going to the third, so I think good things from both teams, but Godsent this time didn't make those key errors that cost them the first map.
I think we need to put things a little in perspective here, because I was saying that I don't know if they can mentally recover after that close loss on Kobol, and they were down 6-0 in the first half and 6-0 in the second half, so losing both pistol, losing the first gun round in both halves, basically being 12-0 down when you look at it, and they still managed to be the first ones who get to match point. So that's an amazing feat in itself. You could tell in the first half on the CT side that they were determined to continue with the aggression all the time. Even when they were losing rounds, they still stuck with it. Then they started winning rounds because of it. But the clear approach they have to playing against NIP, because it is something that can really work when a team is spread out in their defaults with aggression. You can maybe pick them off. It's how some teams approach playing against Na'Vi.
And Robin, we saw, I mean, glimmers from NIP, not enough for it to convert it into a win. I have to address the team play side of things, because it does feel like Godsent are playing as such a unit so early on in their kind of life as a team.
Yeah, I mean, again, same as Cobblestone on Train here on CT side, very aggressive play, go as a unit and get some map control, get that entry and fall back. They do this like every other round, and it always works out. And I mean, they do a great job in it. And the same on the T side, you see them going into a deficit 4-on-5, even 3-on-5, and they still managed to capitalize on that and actually win rounds. And I was saying coming into the game where, I mean, these are young players coming into playing on a big stage, being, like Young was saying, 6-0 down on both sides, and still managed to come back and crawl back and get the match point first, even win in overtime. Yeah, I mean, props. And this just believes, you know, throughout the tournament as well, Twist has been amazing. I mean, for me, he's not even an up-and-coming superstar anymore, because he's been around for so long. But if he sticks to playing like this, you're in for a treat on Mirage.
And I mean, he's been like the best entry fragger of the tournament at the moment.
He's insane.
And also, as Duncan pointed out, that NIP are, you know, win these clutch rounds on the CT side. This is where they had some mistakes and issues. A couple of times in a 3v2 round, you know, Freiberg being in the bomb site, maybe should have just shoulder peeked to get information. He goes for a wide peek, loses the duel, then his teammates are in an unfavorable position. And that happened maybe once or twice, I mean, which is enough in a game that goes to overtime. If only one of those rounds was maybe played a bit better, they could have won it in regulation. But yeah, in the end, you can't take anything away from the Godsent guys. Also, Schneider had some great entry kills. Him and Piss seem to, every other round, they get a kill on each other. Yeah, but the only thing that I can also say about NIP on the city side, they seem to be unaware of the T's constantly pushing out from mid towards T hell, the so-called position, and they were getting shot in the back a couple of times. So maybe the comms were a bit off in that situation as well.
I was just about to counter on that. Honax, when he used to play for Fnatic, same approach. You saw Olaf Meiser every single round go out from T connector into T hell and get a bunch of frags from there. You saw that this game as well, Pronax. You see there what, like, the impact he has on this team, just transferring over some of the attacks he had for Fnatic, moving over here. Now with Schneider instead, going out there, just getting a lot of control. NIP, and NIP had issues versus Fnatic with same strat. You see here now versus Godsent, same thing, same issues. So yeah, I mean, great pick by them. They had a great game plan coming into it, and it worked out. And it's going to be fun to see now if you know, for NIP on Mirage, if they actually talk about the early aggression from Godsend on the CT side.
Yeah, and that is going to be the kind of final closing question. It has to be incredibly quick, Duncan, but do just let the people that perhaps aren't so educated on NIP on Mirage. I mean, let's be fair, sure. There's not too much evidence for Godsend on Mirage, but going into Ninjas on Mirage is our final map of the semi-final.
Yeah, well, this was the map where when they went IEM Katowice, the first LAN where they used the pit lineup, this was actually the map they were trying to play every time, pretty much. But they showed some pretty good actually aptitude on the map, bearing in mind, admittedly, other teams hadn't maybe experienced them as much on it, but they looked like their most well-rounded maps, the one they wanted to get to every time they could. And especially, they had a very exciting win where they were able to beat Luminosity, who's one of the best in the world on this map, and really, really pioneered how you play it. So I think some very, very good signs for NIP. For me, I think NIP's going to come with a solid performance again. My question mark is still on those young players for the Godsend team. Like, are they going to hold up? They've done it two maps in a row. That in itself is very impressive. But the third map, there's even more pressure now. This is where all the veterans have been many, many times. And if anything, they're kind of like, it's just a marathon for them. They're waiting for the endurance aspect. If we can get them deep into those waters, that's when they're going to get worried. So I think NIP's going to take it in the end.
All right. Well, I mean, this is where champions are formed, right? This is the first tournament for some of these players that they've been in a situation like this. To be turned up to your first tournament in a huge offline arena, and then you're sitting there one map away, one game of Counter-Strike away from the grand finals and that lion's share of $250,000. It's definitely a bit of a fairy tale storyline for Letcro and the boys, and it is time for us to delve into Mirage. Your casters are ready, and so let's do it one more time. Metis and Moses, you better enjoy this one. The Scory Sports.
Why not, Alex?
I love that plug at the end.
Why not? The Scory Sports. Well done.
I think we are going to enjoy this. It's safe to say.
Yeah, this has exceeded expectations in every way. I think this Godsend team is showing poise above their experience, above their level that we thought coming into this event. This has been absolutely insane out of them, and it's almost like throw out what you know in this third map, because it's gonna get wild.
Absolutely. And to come back, as the desk was talking about, from such massive deficits when you're already hamstringed almost right off the bat, to get yourself back into the game, and it goes to overtime, and I'm thinking, okay, this is where Godsend start to just slip away, right? This is where NIP are going to take their stranglehold. They're going to walk away with this. We're going 2-0. For Godsend to bounce back, I mean, that shows great grit, and that's got to be a worrying sign for NIP.
Especially if you're losing that first map so close.
Exactly.
And then to stand strong in overtime, you're exactly right. That's something we don't normally see. Normally, that's where you spot like the inexperienced team, the younger team kind of collapse, but all these players have stepped up. And we are going to get live into this third and final map between NIP and Godsend. The winning team goes to the grand finals of DreamHack Masters. They'll be facing against Na'Vi.
DE Mirage is the map. It all came down to this. Both maps have been so close. So for the final time today, guys, in this semi-final, let's hear you. An all-Swedish affair in Sweden. And it promises to be a sick final map as well. CT side is going to be Godsend. NIP on the aggression, sending two players right away over into B apps. And Letcro is there to hold off the push for now. Bomb now transitioning through T spawn, going to be joining onto Getright, who is in A site.
Yeah, Letcro did insane damage, but Getright has such an advanced position over towards A. He's already got out. He hasn't been spotted. Palf, I think, maybe spotted him. He's playing so passively in CT spawn. He does not want to get punished. Maybe thinking this is going to try and be some kind of split towards the B bomb site. Everyone from Godsend is all the way over at the B site. This is insane. I don't think NIP realizes how good they have it at the moment. Freiburg falls. Bomb is being planted. Getright and Force have a huge job to do.
Yeah, grass is always greener on the other side. NIP have got the bomb down, but it's at great cost. Two players dead. Pits are extremely low. Getright's going to look to try and bag himself. This kill into Letcro does finally get it. Meanwhile, Pit has fallen, 2v4. We've seen NIP clutch rounds from these kind of situations before, but they've been smoked off. This makes it that much harder. Forrest charges through. He is going to find himself in the receiving end of a battering. Here comes Getright. He gets life, but peeks around and destroys Twist. And now this clutch is doable. Getright, surely Godsend haven't just let this round slip away. He's been dinked, but the time is down, and Getright is going to clutch the round. You can see what it means to him. He's hyped. He's ready to get into this one. They tried to knife him.
That is, I don't know if he was out of bullets or if he was just trying to make a play, but that should not happen at this level. This is not the time to be going for that knife. And Getright somehow pulls off a miracle. That is an incredible round to win. And NIP goes up 1-0 in the unlikeliest of situations.
There's a 2v4 as well. Godsent. That should have been theirs. Lecro gets the first kill on Biaps. He's there again now with the Deagle. And these are the kind of mistakes that are going to cost you in the long run. Are Nip going to go ahead and open up a 6-0 lead again? Pit opens up this round at least. He's been tanked down to 16. NIP again, similar to the last round, deciding to sweep around with the bomb. Not entirely sure where they want to go just yet.
It doesn't matter at the moment. This is just their standard anti-eco. Just don't make any mistakes. Play very far back. They've already got one kill on Twist, and now they can kind of grind this round out with a big advantage. Everyone from NIP, they were poised over towards the B bomb site, just setting up far back and mid. Now they're going to reconvene over towards the A site, but that's where Godsent is stacking. They do have three members here, including the Deagle on Pronax. So all five members going to line up. Schneider's playing close. It's Palf and Pronax who are playing back towards Connector. And that nade, look at the utility use and these anti-ecos from NIP. It's so superb. Schneider does get one kill, but it's an easy trade because of the HE grenade. And the smokes are lined up. Palf and Pronax cannot get into this round. They're going to have to just run through, see what they can find. Pronax has an opportunity. Brings Exist very low, or brings Freiburg low, and that is eventually traded off. And actually, now that the rotation has come in, there's a little bit of a chance here.
Certainly is. It's going to require one Deke, and Lecro is going to supply it. Now it starts to get a bit precarious. 15 seconds left. They don't have CT control. 12 seconds. This opens up their opportunities now for Nip. And now Lecro is going to try and get the frag on the retreat. Lands it on to get right. One versus one now. It stands to reason this kind of situation, the last player would be around Tetris or Ramp. He would have spotted him if he went into Palace. And Lecro has sussed this one out. He is absolutely certain that Tetris is the last remaining player. One taps onto Forest. Back-to-back craziness. And Godsent will bounce back into this in the best possible way. Lecro, take a bow. That was disgusting.
What a really ridiculous turn of events in these past two rounds. So Godsent, they fluff the pistol. They make a massive mistake. But Lecro, he makes up for it in this round. So many sick shots. All tied up at 1-1. I said we're gonna have to throw the rule book out, but this is unreal.
This is taking it a few steps too far. NIP, of course, will be forcing into this, try and break the economy before it can get steamrolling across. This is the best start that Godsent have had, by the way, in this best of three so far.
Oh, and NIP, they don't want to give up the advantage just yet. They have the buy of the Tech-9's armor, Pith with the Deagle. Getright has the AK-47s. And he's going to move up. Hit is the first one into the site with this Deagle, trying to find something. He's blind at the moment. They have at least forced the defense back. There's a kill from Forrest. Very well could trade some rounds, but Pronax through the smoke finds one.
NIP have got the bomb planted, though. Godsent needs to get a move on. They still got plenty of smokes and flashes to use. Nothing to draw out enemies, though. No incendiaries, no HEs. Good positions held from NIP thus far, and they also have themselves Getright, who's coming up from Connector. Can he get there in time, though? The rest of his team, barring Exist, have died, and Schneider was watching out for that. Now it's all on Exist, going to be charging up ramp. The bomb is being defused. First kill goes down for him. Oh, he just doesn't have enough bullets. He doesn't have enough power. And Palf will get that defuse, albeit very closely without a kit. But still, Godsent will take the 2-1 lead.
Yeah, NIP at least get the bomb down. They do some economic damage, but they just didn't have the arsenal to hold off that retake. Mostly Tech-9s. Some good shots with the M4, kind of clean that out. So NIP do have to concede. This round, they're going to be a very light buy, if anything, a very light investment. They do have Getright gets, oh no, they go right for it. They come right back into this. So two AKs on Forrest and Exist. It's a Deagle on Freiburg, the Tech-9s on Getright and Pit. They have good utility as well. They want to stop this right here. Opportunity for Freiburg. He's blind. Exist gets one kill, trades away from Schneider, brings it into a 4-on-4. Freiburg is Molotov. He's got to use a smoke to stay alive.
Even though Freiburg was heavily flashed up, he did knock Twist down to just 8 health. So the damage has been inflicted on both teams. And this now gives NIP a fighting chance to maybe get themselves across this B site. However, again, we're going to see the tag team duo pushing through there. It's going to be Pronax and Lecro looking to get some frags down. Lecro lands the headshot onto Exist. Bomb dropped outside of the T side of B app, so easily recoverable. But again, NIP are taking heavy damage here, Moses. Not looking good.
We've seen this from Godset on every map in this series. It's this mid-round aggression on the CT side. It's been so difficult for NIP to handle. I mean, this time it gets him a kill. It dinks Freiburg down to 5. He's essentially out of the fight. Pith is very low at the top of mid. There's really not too many options available for NIP now.
Have to come down to some pretty ridiculous entries onto the site. 40 seconds left. Bomb still in the hands of NIP. Get right pushing up from underpass. That Molly will keep the CTs at bay. Can't afford to peek just yet, but they have the player up on the boxes and short, but he gets picked off from Get Right. That's a pretty big kill as well. And one that, honestly, Pronak should be getting at least a kill from that position.
It makes you believe a little bit more in NIP this round, but the big issue is Twist is on the flank through T-spawn. 20 seconds left. NIP has to go towards this B bomb site. Palp is rotated over as well. Twist is going to have a quick flank. Lekro just has to stay alive. Just has to bide his time. There's a kill, and there it is. It's a cleanup for Godsent. And finally, NIP with no bomb plant here. They're going to have to just give it up. They've had a lot of force buys as this losing bonus builds, but no one is over 3K. So this round is going to be a little bit easier for Godsent.
Yep, the economic game of chicken has gone the way of Godsent, as NIP will be tapping out this round. Upgraded pistols, but that's about all. They will be able to get the AKs next round, of course, with the round loss coming in. And two bomb defusals, but a solid hold from Godsent in the end. MP9 for Twist, see if he can get some money in the bank. And another peek through mid. This time it's Schneider that's going to hold that one down. He does actually get dinked there. Down to 53. That grenade has damage written all over it. Forest will drop pretty low. Three players in underpass looking to try and boost their way up, but they're being caught off. Freiburg actually lands the shot. Oh, a second one tapped as well. And out of nowhere, now Godsent the relink. They're staggering. Can an IP go in for the killing blow, though?
Not quite yet, because they haven't picked up. They haven't been able to salvage any of these guns. Yes, they've lost players, but Godsent is still okay because no rifle's salvaged. With no armor, no utility, and actually very low HP on three members. And look at Palf, he's on an information gathering mission coming through underpass. Everyone from Godsend has actually rotated over towards this B bomb site. If Nip hurries this up, they have no way of knowing this. But this A bomb site is completely clear. The only issue is, since they don't know, they're going to take this a little bit slower. So that allows the opportunity for Schneider to rotate back towards this A bomb site. He's going to be here in time. And now, I mean, Palf just continuing his push. He's saying, we don't know what's going on. I'm going to go hunting for the info, and he's about to find it. Forrest in middle is going to try and support as best he can, but it's Schneider who's going to be the first line of defense with Lekro.
Yeah, Palv's push is giving so much information across to the CTs now, though. NIP almost in deadlock. They can't afford to wait too much longer. Lekro's AK and Schneider are going to both chime in, and that's pretty much the round slipping away from NIP now. It's got a whole lot worse. Lekro is going to pick up his second and third kills of the round. Full house of frag, Schneider with 2, Lekro with 3, and Godsent now going to be facing off against AK-47s from Nip. This is the best buy we've seen from Nip so far.
Lekro is having a breakout performance in the series on the stage here, as if he didn't already have one with his 30-kill map 3 performance just the other day. I mean, now against NIP, he's been solid across all three maps.
Oh, yeah.
10-for-1 right now. Started this off blistering pace. Will he be able to keep it up, though? If he does, you'd fancy Godsent to clutch out this map as well. Aggression for Twist, going right up mid. He is going to get punished for that aggression, though. Pit is there to retaliate. Pronax, meanwhile, going to be throwing the incendiary up onto the mid boxes. Does force away a couple of terrorists to pick that bomb up, relocate, but that's a huge opening pick for NIP.
Yeah, not just that, but exists in the underpass, biding his time, deals good damage on a Pronax, forces back the aggression of Godsent. Schneider's the only one there now. Because all of his teammates were forced away, Schneider gets caught overcommitting. 5-on-3 for NIP, and they need this round, but Godsent is on another one of their aggression, their mid-round aggression. Pronax is going to push up. He gets found out by Get Right. Not fooled whatsoever. And now Lekro, there he is with a nice headshot on a Forest. And Palf over towards the A-bomb, so the defense is completely split, 1-1 at each site.
Oh.
And this is just, he's just crossing his fingers.
Exist. Doesn't realize he just walks straight past, and to be fair, I don't think that Palf does either. Oh, Lekrat, so unfortunate. You hate to see it happen. Now, bomb planted on A. Palf with a huge task ahead of him. Freiburg lands the headshot. He's been stepping up over this last map or so. NIP finally double their amount here on Mirage. Godsent's economy is in shape to go for a buy here. Not going to be a great one, though.
And it almost seems like Godsent has won over some of this crowd, because the chants have gotten a little bit quieter. for NIP. It's more just cheering for the good Counter-Strike we're seeing. Freiburg going for some mid-control Molotov and connector. He's dealt a lot of damage. There's the AWP through the smoke. Schneider finds it.
Now, returning the favor. And yeah, I think out of this tournament, Godsent would get themselves a lot of fans. So, the way they've been playing, battling against the odds, they have a very entertaining strategic outlook as well, especially maps like Mirage. Like, seeing them play so aggressively is very fun to watch. But is it going to be efficient? That's the question. Still in the early days here on Mirage, 4-2. But with Freiburg being the first person to fall, and IP now need to go ahead and pick that bomb up. We've seen them drop it around there a bunch of times. Boost coming up now for Godsent, looking in with the AWP from Schneider. Again, Get Right will be lurking towards the ramp. No information really gathered from either side, though, thus far.
Forsen exists. Oh, that's a lost battle. Pronex gets exists, and that was huge. That could have helped NIP a lot, gain the mid control. They know Pronex is at least in ladder room, although he's getting away right now, and Pitt's got to try and chase this down. It's not going to work. Forrest falls as well. Get Right on that lurk. Hasn't been able to do anything. Biding his time, waiting for his moment. It's just never come, so he's forced away. 30 seconds left in a 1-on-5. He does find a kill on the Schneider. Is he going to be aware there's one more on Catwalk? He's got to hear the shots now. He's going to win that battle as well. Transfers over, just pre-fires in case. But 20 seconds left. That jump just lets him know people are here, but he's not going to win that one. 5-2. Godsent go up big. It resets the losing bonus. There's enough money. I mean, there's enough money on the NIP side if they want to force buy again. We saw it a lot early on in this half, but they cannot continue to do that if they're not going to have success. But they're going to go for it one more time. And it's a decent buy. It's 3 AK-47s, full utility. Galil with nothing, and the Deagle on Freiburg with a little bit.
Well, this is a power play from NIP. If Godsent lose this, they'll be into an eco. At least their economy is going to be in a really sketchy position. So, again, we find ourselves in one of those kind of scenarios where a lot rides on this. Godsent, again, maybe realizing that NIP have a very slow, steady, methodical approach to the T side. They're going to try and make the most of that, get themselves real estate, get themselves off angles. Just try and force through and fill in the gaps. Three players over on the B side for now for Godsent.
Standard mid control for NIP. This time they're not challenged. There's actually a very heavy B lean. Pronax is on catwalk and two in the B bomb site, so maybe Godsent trying to read something. Freiburg takes early damage. Pronax remaining aggressive on catwalk. He wants to go for more, but Freiburg already evacuates before the Molotov comes into play. And still, no losses taken from either team. A lot of utility is being used by both sides, though, and it's NIP who's going to be on the losing end of that. They've got a smoke, a flash, and a Molotov left. This is not going to come down to an execution. NIP is going to have to find a pick somewhere.
Yeah, it's going to have to be brute force. You have to feel for NIP. As you mentioned before, they had a smoke. It's been used from Exist, just a Molly in a flashbang. Desperately trying to find a player to pick off. So far, the CTs are just digging themselves in deep. Exist is going to try and push through connector.
Yeah, and Godsent is playing a heavy lean towards the B bomb site. Pronax is going to be the one who's got to find the intel. He's going to have the first battle. They're peering up at him, but that's a sick shot for Pronax. And a second one as well. He holds strong initially. Two kills for him, and that forces Forrest to be a little bit more passive. But Twist finds him anyway. Get Right and Exit, or in Pit. They have something to do, and it's Get Right with two opening kills. So brought it down into a 2-on-3. He's going to remain aggressive, but there's no time on the clock. Forces him into an awkward duel. And Godsent again outlasts the buys from NIP.
Yeah, and he was forced into that duel as well. With 7 seconds, you don't want to die after time. That's just going to hamper you even further. But here's the Pronax play. Absolutely sick aim. Alleviate so much pressure from mid. Then Twist came in just afterwards. And just like that, NIP's chances were all but gone. NIP's economy now, you can see after that buy, pretty much ruined.
It's a critical play from Pronax as well. And this is really cool. So this, in case you guys, new viewer to Counter-Strike, it was a team called Very Games, a French team, and this was known as like the Exist timeout, where essentially you're getting so stumped, but it's too early or you don't want to use your tactical pause. You just stay very, very far back on the map. You don't buy anything, and this is just them talking things over. This is them using this round as a timeout. So obviously a little bit rattled by this defense early on, because it has been very, very efficient.
12-3 sits Lecro. Again, Get Right. Really the only player that's been pulling anything off with 10-7. Pronax going to be peeking up short again. As you mentioned before, Moses, just sitting back, just discussing things, maybe hoping that one of Godsent's players goes for that information grabbing as we've seen a couple times through the T side of B apps and see if we can get a free kill and get that weapon. but Godsent aren't budging.
It'll be interesting. I mean, it'll be interesting to see what NIP is going to do in the next round, because the losing bonus is not fully built up. They only have two rounds of it, so it's not like they're going to be sitting on a bunch of cash. I don't think they'll be able to have an AWP, and if they do, it'll be Glass Cannon. And now NIP making their move. 35 seconds left on the clock. They've talked over whatever they want. Maybe it's just to calm down. I know a lot of teams just say it's not really about what you decide to change tactically. It's just, you know, getting your mind centered, releasing, like, figuring out any frustrations you had, get them away, get your mind clear, and just move on with the match. But for now, just all Glocks, no armor. This should be a pretty easy mop-up. Lekro with a chance to have a really sick round here, but Twist, it's the last two. It's a Ninja's Barbecue.
Pretty comfortable in the end, but that was effectively a throwaway round for NIP. Here we go. Now we've got the AKs back in. Pitt's going to get himself the AK. NIP quickly finding themselves in a position that Gods didn't have the previous two maps, and that's being well and truly up against it. Five rounds behind already.
This is a different tactic. This is them saying there's been a lot of emphasis from mid control on Gods sent. So instead of spreading out, instead of trying to take that from them, they're just going to go for a standard A execute, because if you have a lot of bodies at mid control, you're usually playing very passive in the A bomb site. Splashes rain out. Quick aggression from NIP.
Here we go then, Pit on the box is going to be trying to do what he can, shifting up the aggression here on NIP, and it's seemingly working well for them to start things off. Exist is there. Forrest watches the close angle. Actually, on the other side of the box is so unfortunate, and somehow Godsent are not only holding their ground, but they're forcing NIP back. They have the player advantage. The bomb's been picked up. It will get planted from Get Right. Pit still watching his teammates back. But this retake is very doable. There's three smokes in play. Pit's there though, lands the shot onto Pauf. Get Right's gonna be pulling himself back. The spray control's on point. The first kill goes down, but he's not gonna get the second. And Pronax will get the defuse. Godsent will move six rounds ahead. NIP could see what they were going for, a more aggressive approach, but it just simply backfires.
Pronax gets the defuse. He gets four kills in the round. A hero performance from him. And it's not just that, it's the read. Whoever called it out, as soon as they feel no pressure in mid, Godsent immediately falls out of that setup and they rotate two players very quickly over towards CT spawn. So they actually have a very, very large presence very quickly when NIP takes that site, and NIP was not prepared for it. The ninjas just kind of fall under the slaughter from Godsent. After two very close first maps, we saw Godsent recover from such a huge deficit and on train. NIP is going to have to do the same exact thing now.
Yeah, we've seen Godsent come from behind and claw the way back into maps. How do they lead maps? Are they going to struggle to get over the finish line? Freiburg's 1D opens things up. He did take a lot of damage though. Here comes another charge onto the A side. Pauf is there with two kills. Very nicely done. He does get dinked though for his trouble. Schneider, meanwhile, is going to do the business for his team. That flash not quite paying out. Ooh, Zeiss through the boxes. Going to make this round a little bit more interesting. Looking to transfer his prey across, and it's came full circle. Freiburg got the first kill. And now, with his Deagle and his Galil, has to try and finish off three more Godsent players. Not going to happen. Godsent taking a commanding lead now. That was another force buy as well from NIP.
And the question now becomes, when do they use their actual tactical timeout? They're getting stumped. Everything they've tried to catch Godsent off guard by hitting A fast and without any indication, with no actual execute. That hasn't worked. Mid control has been beaten back. NIP's running out of options, and they've only got four rounds left in this half, and this one is going to be conceded over towards just Tech9 and Armor.
Filtering out this time, though. Get Right again is going to be lurking towards the ramp. Also got Freiburg in mid for the Tech9. The rest of the team is going to be looking to get round underpass. Very aggressive charge, actually, out from Forrest, who's on the site, completely catching Lekro unawares. Was not expecting that kind of aggression. But Forrest is by himself. Here comes Exist. The Tech9s are doing the business. Forrest and Freiburg now looking to get more frags. Freiburg, the wrong side of the smoke. But there's Get Right. So these Tech9s have done such a good job. Pit now comes in. And it's going to finish off with Freiburg. What is going on here? Everyone bags himself a kill in that round. NIP, in a round you just don't expect anything to happen, have picked up their third.
Well, they used the mobility of the Tech9 very well. Forrest is the first one out over towards B bomb site. He essentially runs through smokes and just jumps out, catches the one B defender off guard, and that kind of spreads out the defense. They were no longer grouped up. Exist is boosted in the window through smoke as well, so it is very ninja-like, just coming out of the smoke, finding your kill. and just eventually overrunning the defense. And they finally, they've done it. They've reset the economy. You can see Godsent on just pistols now. They have a couple players with armor. But this is an opportunity now for Ninjas in Pajamas to catch up on the scoreboard.
Yeah, if the Ninjas get back into this game, that could be the moment. Let's set everything in motion. Or is Lepro going to do the impossible? No, he's not. Just 2-1 taps. I say just 2-1 taps. That does give Godsent a chance now. The only problem is that with those two kills, out of no man's land, none of the rest of the CTs could pick up those weapons. They only have pistols to get themselves back on this site with. So it's not looking good for them. However, Pronax is there with the CZ. Pit and Forest have a tall task ahead of them. Pit going for the spray, randomly gets two. Now it's all on Forest. He's up in the BX, they know exactly where he is. First frag comes down for him. This is so important. Nip desperately need this one. Forest is playing it smart. There's no kit in the hands of the CTs, and Forest is gonna get the clutch. NIP do convert after breaking the economy, but my goodness, they made a meal of it.
For how good NIP has been throughout this tournament on Anti-Ecos, the analyst has talked about it, we've talked about it. These are six shots from Lecro. But for them to have dropped the second round after winning the pistol, and then that round comes that close, Godsent has found a way to make these work.
Just ridiculous individual performance from Lecro. 17 for 6 now. As you say, those 2-1 digs are pretty special. Just the FAMAS in the hands of Pronax, but the rest of the team is pretty solid, pretty healthy in terms of weaponry. NIP desperately need these 6 rounds. And they need to come to the halftime scoreline with something to play with. Looks like it's going to be an A-centric push again. Pronax right through mid, catches Freiburg completely unawares.
There it is again, and that's solo aggression. That's not even the coordinated aggression we've seen out of Godsent in the past, and we're about to see it here again. Lecro and Twist in the B halls are about to start just working their way up slowly. Actually, 4 members of Godsent at this bomb site. Now Pronax is going to rotate away. The A hit is on. Palp is the only one here. He's got to play it passive. He's got to just play for the retake. Not smoked off yet, so he has a chance here to get a pick. But he's waiting for his teammates to arrive.
And meanwhile, Lecro is starting to charge his way all the way around the back of the T-spawn, so watch out for him. If he can time himself right, he could be in the money with some frags. Meanwhile, the rest of his team trying to hold down from CT boxes. Important kill from Schneider. Here comes Pit now, next up on the chopping block. And meanwhile, as I mentioned, Lecro has managed to get himself through into Palace. Forest is there. Get Right can hear noise ahead of him. He knows what's coming up. Just going to be holding Shadow. Lecro's not going to check this. It's going to be at the cost of his life. Gets round the corner, but it's going to get picked off anyway. It's a long twist with the AWP. First kill comes down. This is so crucial for NIP again. Forest is going to be holding the angle, but he's got no smokes. And Twist decides to tap out. He had a kit, but realized he had no chance of holding on to that. NIP will pick up a 5th round.
That is such a dangerous round for NIP, and they pull it out again. These are getting so close, but Get Right with the patience underneath Balcony. And finally, these 3 rounds in a row have gotten the crowd back into it. Nip is back in the game. And this buy, it's a fortunate situation that Twist saved the AWP because it's essentially all they have. 3 pistols, the Mag 7, or excuse me, they have a Deagle on Lecro. So that's been just as good.
Yeah, it's been ridiculous. Speaking of which, you had a chance there.
If he had hit that shot, I would have just walked off.
Just rage quit. It was pretty close by the looks of things. Well, he does eat quite a bit of damage, as does Twist, down to 39. Freiburg, meanwhile, we've seen him hold this position a bunch of times with the Deagle, now with the AK on mid-boxes. Filtering out, mainly stacked towards the B-side at the moment from NIP. He's just going to try and work through underpass. And with Godsent's lack of weaponry, they are playing this one fairly passively so far. You often see teams in this kind of situation maybe try a bit of aggression somewhere. That's not the case here for Godsent.
They still have the AWP, so what they're trying to do, that's a nice kill from Exist. That opens things up nicely. Pronax is going to take his position, though. Counter aggression where he just lost a teammate. And initially catches Freiburg off guard, but they managed to fall away. So all of NIP is just going to evacuate mid now. But what they're trying to do is figure out where NIP is going, because they still have this AWP. And if they can get Twist in the right spot, he's pretty much gambling at this B bomb site most of this round. Now he's kind of going to cheat away. It felt no pressure in B halls. Pronax is now pushed up. They're going to clear out mid. Zep Pit is there, and he's not going to let him do it.
Spots the second player in Connector. He's going to get peeked from window as well at the same time. A solid work from Godsent. 20 seconds left. Bomb finally starting to push its way onto the site. And it's Twist, who started the round with the AWP, still has it in his hands. An AK in the hands of Palf is going to put down Freiburg, looking for this boost. The bomb still hasn't been planted just yet. 6 seconds left. A key kill though onto Palf. That does allow them to get this bomb planted. 2 seconds to go. They look to charge right in. What is happening? Schneider with two kills. Gets picked off finally. Twist misses his chance. Looking for it on the second time of asking, but get right. The player he'd want in that situation picks up his 15th kill and gives Nip their sixth round.
We should have known, Metas, that NIP was not going to go down without a fight. It looks so dire there, but the last four rounds gets NIP up towards six on their terror side. A dominant start to that half from Godsent, but some insane clutches towards the end. It does bring him back. So we are going to send it down to Paula on the floor because he's probably got the pulse of the crowd.
Thank you very much, Jason. There was a huge, huge roar there for Nip. Although I do feel that any Swedish team making it to the final against Na'Vi is probably going to be supported just as well as the other. We will have to see who wins this match and goes on to that final.
Thank you very much, Paula. So the crowd has been lucky in this game, as have we, to be fair.
It almost seems like they don't know who to cheer for anymore.
Yeah. I think, as I said before, I think Godsent have picked up a lot of fans as a result of this performance over this tournament. Especially on home soil as well. You feel like whichever team goes through to the finals and have the full crowd backing them.
Certainly, yeah, certainly sounds to be the case here as the floor is shaking now. Pistol round begins. An NIP, very big lean towards mid. Freiburg peeking window. Force and Pit are going to get aggressive off catwalk, but it's going to be heavy towards the A bomb site for Godsent. Schneider is forced away, but the smoke is out. Exist can see nothing. And Godsent is actually going to push towards connector. Freiburg is waiting for this. Nice shot from Pit, though. He gets the opening kill. Now Murderhole is aggressed upon, but Get Right is there. Puts a stop to it. This was all an elaborate fake, and it's not working out whatsoever for Godsent.
Good damage done from Twist. Long range with a Glock. Very nearly picks up the kill into Pit. Critical round for both teams as well. This gets Nip right back into it. You assume from this point they're going to clutch it, but we did see a 2v4 clutch in the first pistol round go the way of NIP. 5v3 is not impossible for Godsent. Here comes the boost into window, it would seem, for Schneider with the block.
This shouldn't find anything, though. Get Right and Freiburg are playing this very passively, just spotting the murder hole. Get Right's head is exposed very, very quickly, so now he has a little bit of intel, but, I mean, since they're playing it so passively, that's a good find. Schneider does get that kill. Pronak still over towards the B bomb site, but Pitt and Forrest, they haven't rotated away from this. There's no reason for them to. Schneider is just causing a distraction. Exist still hasn't spotted anything at A. So still going to be a very, very tough sell for Godsent here.
You can see what Schneider's trying to do. He's trying to play the bait while the rest of his team makes some inroads towards the site. Again, though, Nip are not falling for this. Here comes the bomb. Be moving its way onto the A play. The bomb plant in this kind of situation would probably be okay as far as Godsent are concerned, but it could go a whole lot better. It's now down to a 2-on-3 from a 5v3, and with Pit only a bullet away from death and Forrest down to 64, now 27 health. This could get really sketchy real quick, but there's Freiburg. Twist now has it all to do, and Pit is going to get his second kill. NIP will pick up the second pistol round as well.
Yeah, but now it becomes avoid falling to Lekro's Deagle, or Twist Deagle, or any Deagle. NIP have to sustain this. That's what put him in such a hole in that first half. They couldn't recover in terms of their economy for so long that Godsent just kept having massive advantages. NIP cannot have a slow start to this half the way they did in the first.
Well, simply put, if they had that kind of start, they will lose this map, very likely. They don't have the rounds to play with. They're on the CT side now. It's harder to bounce back, economically speaking. So they've got to keep this going forward. There are no Deagles in play, though, for Godsent. Actually, just the P250, so opting for the full AKs in the next round instead after that bomb plant. Bomb dropped at spawn. A boost up here for Godsent.
This is actually, I think this might be the first time we haven't seen them buy any Deagles in these second rounds. Yep. Perhaps because they may be going for a third round buy here. That's what this would indicate to me. And if NIP, I mean, once they see what weapons are at hand, they're going to expect that as well. Godsent playing this very passively, but NIP, I mean, this is the thing. On their anti-ecos, they don't move across the map. They don't overextend. Pitt's just searching for info at the top of mid. But he's not going to commit to any fight he finds there.
Threat really has drilled into them this concept of being patient and anti-eco, is not giving anything away. And Godsent will know this as well. Slowly but surely moving across to the B side. P250 on Pronax, all that they really have in terms of power. Get right's waiting. The flash comes in. Pure timing. They have no idea where Godsent are at this point. No information has been given across.
And they call it off. For whatever reason, they found a read and they decided not to hit that B bomb site. Now they're just going to go towards mid, whether it be catwalk, as it just gets smoked off. Pitt's going to be looking around the edge. He finds the first kill. That's forced, excuse me. So attention in mid, there's really no utility for them to make progress anywhere. All they're doing is trying to find a couple kills. They do get one.
That was so awkward. You could see Pitt desperately wanted to kill him, but his teammate was in his face. Get out the way. Don't want a team kill you. That cost his teammate his life. I think it was Forrest.
It's not very punishing these days. No reason not to take it.
True.
And here it is. Here's the third round by. Is NIP going to be ready for it? They have all the utility. Critical round here for Godsent. Four AK-47s, UMP on Pronax. That gives him a little bit extra utility. That gives him a Molotov, perhaps. He's going to use it in window room. Looking to be relatively fast-paced. Godsent. Pronax is going to lead his way up. Catwalk, is Pitt going to be ready? He's got nades out. Pronax does get in the cover of ladder room, but Pitt's got to be very careful. And he still has a nade out. Pronax is going to win that battle. Not ready for it whatsoever. No one else at the B bombsite. Pronax is just going to walk up and see this is clear. NIP has to respond somehow.
That's exactly what Getright's going for right now. I'm just going to try and force the issue. Lecro is looking into B apps. He's going to get caught from the P90. Yes, he is. Gets sprayed down. Getright does eat a lot of damage, though, absorbs it. Forrest, meanwhile, cheeky peek. Freiburg, three kills in as many seconds, gives NIP a commanding lead now in round 18. Pronax and Pauf, both residing in mid. But pardon me, Pronax is out on the B site. He's going to get the drop on Getright. Didn't know what hit him.
Yeah, but the bomb is still in mid. It's almost like Godsent didn't expect the B bomb site to be where they finally ended up. And there's no way they could have known it was clear, but Pronax pushes all the way up there, and none of his teammates are in position to take advantage of it. And now Forrest, that might just be the dagger in this round. The bomb is dropped in mid, 40 seconds left. Pronax in a one-on-three, and he has no clue where the other two members of NIP are. One's flanking from behind, that's Exist. And is this timing going to work out? Exist is hiding at the moment, and Pronax might just walk right by him.
Is he going to knife? No. Just go for the kill.
Listen, we already experienced one knife attempt in the third map of a semifinal. Exist knows better than that.
I just wanted to see a knife. We've already seen a couple of shanks so far. I think Schneider got himself a couple of knife kills earlier. But yeah, unfortunate for Pronax. NIP have managed to convert the subsequent rounds after winning that pistol. They were unable to do that in the first half. So 9-9. Looking like they're going to take the lead again as a result of this round. Three players mid stacking up. We do have the Deagle in the hands of Twist and Pronax and Lecro as well.
Yeah, Lecro is going to be very aggressive, but Getright's there to shut him down. Wants no more of that. Pronax working his way up catwalk again. Schneider going to try and come through the smoke. There's Freiburg onto him. Pitt's going to next one to be aggressive. Good shot from Twist though. Returns the favorite. Even Pau finds one. Can't get anything more than that. And there it is, NIP. They take their lead in this match. The first lead since the winning pistol round of the first half. They're up 10-9.
Yep, they've been trailing ever since that first round up until this point. So for a good 18 rounds, they found themselves just desperately chasing. Here comes Godsent though. Full AKs, full grenades. No AWP though. And we've seen they do like to run the AWP on Schneider. Smoke down's going to stop the vision onto window. Make sure that no one gets picked off on the cross. Forrest, meanwhile, is going to use that to his advantage. Just slightly peeking out of connector. This time, Pitt's not going to be caught with a nade out. He's peering across with the AWP.
Yeah, there's a time limit on that play from Forrest, and once it starts to reach the end, he goes for the peek. He goes to make the play instead of waiting for it. Gets punished. So an opening kill for Godsent. They have a minute and 20 seconds with a man advantage. And NIP are running very fast out of utility. They've only got one Molotov on Getright, one flashbang. So at a certain point, you could see on the minimap, Pit with the AWP is just going to play far back in the B bomb site, look to get one pick and stay alive, but it's Exist who's going to try and make the play. They don't have any utility to create anything for themselves. So Exist has got to find the intel to provide them the information that they can rotate to the proper position, but is it going to be quick enough? Smokes are going to start coming out towards this B bomb site, and Get Right is on his way there. But here it comes from Godsend.
Pit needs to connect a couple of these shots, you have to feel. That bomb actually, though, is starting to move across towards mid. That keeps the options open for Godsend. Meanwhile, Exist has managed to snake his way through onto the T side, but that's not going to help his teammate of Freiburg, who was caught all by himself on the site. Now, A has been claimed, but again, Exist could be the difference maker. Get Right. He is going to miss out on his chance. Exist now coming up is going to stop the bomb plant. Down goes the bomb. Schneider's low, and Pitt's starting to move his way in. Can Exist pull off another hero play? He's been mollied out. He's going to have to relocate now, and that could afford them the bomb plant, and indeed it will. Here comes Pitt. And a second as well. It's all on Twist, and he's going to be peeking. Pitt very nearly lands it, but instead it's all on Exist. And there's Exist, finishes off Twist, and NIP will take a two-round lead. Pitt with two massive warp frags, though.
That is Pitt saving the day for NIP. Huge performance coming out of Connector. So difficult at times to clear these angles out. Standing in a Molotov as well. And this, the readjustment of the aim right there at the end. It was nicely done, and he gives just the opportunity Exist needed to win that out. 11-9 now. Godsend still a strong buy. With this losing bonus building up, with the bomb plant, you have the AWP in Schneider's hand. He's got no armor. That's the one, you know, aim punch is going to be an issue. Nades are going to be an issue, but he has been very, very effective with this weapon throughout the series. And at the moment, no one from NIP going to challenge initially.
Yeah, the glass cannon AWP for Schneider. He is typically an AWP that's going to pounce on every opportunity he's given, so it may not end up being a huge issue. He is peering across from mid. No one's home, though, for NIP. Starting to see that Forrest decides to take more of a passive position. We've seen him pushing out a connector a couple times. It has cost him his life. Going to be peeking out. He could get double peeked, though, from both catwalk and mid. Going to go for the flashbang. No one's home, though, in Palace. That flashes his teammates in, so they're going to try and look for that information, but while doing so, they could get pushed from behind. So Forrest is the linchpin at this point. If he falls down, this entire A defense could as well.
He just got so lucky as well, not realizing there's a huge gap in that smoke. Almost gets punished, but he's going to get aggressive. He's going to try and be a little bit creative. Gets in front of it. And there is a boost. Pronax is inside of the window, and that might be the game-changing point. Although Forrest finds the opening kill on a twist. Pronax still hasn't moved. He could catch him off guard. Exist again, pushing up. Grabs a lot of intel and saw at least two players. Does a little bit of damage on a Schneider, but falls away. Doesn't want to risk his life. This is a very Fnatic-esque play coming out from Pronax. Mid-control leads to a boosted player, and then they rotate back towards A. And Forrest, I don't think he's going to expect this whatsoever. He's about to fall here, although here's the footsteps. Get Right gets the kill, saves his life. Forrest still alive, is going to get one more, and now Exist biding his time. It's a slaughter for the ninjas.
Man, Get Right's kill there was absolutely huge for NIP. If he doesn't land that, you'll just start to see Godsend pushing through onto the site. Here comes the pause. Godsend out of ideas, going to try and figure out what's going wrong. NIP have shifted into a different gear right now.
Yeah, this is when they become really, really scary, isn't it? I mean, Pit bails them out of a tough round, but I mean, players like Get Right Exist. The amount of impact plays that Exist has had throughout the series, throughout this tournament even, has been incredible. He's hit a new level than we've seen him at in some time. But Get Right, certainly the face, the star of this team, 20-16 for him in this match.
There's the brains behind the operation for NIP Threat. They really have looked invigorated since he's joined.
And this
fantastic.
And this is where you talk about Godsend and you'd say, okay, the younger players, the more inexperienced players, this is where, you know, they really start to struggle. Are they going to be able to recover from it? The question has kind of been answered in the first two maps of the series. They handled the pressure very nicely. Especially on Train, when we thought there was a couple different points they could have collapsed in that. But they forced it into overtime there. Here is a different situation. NIP is starting to run away with this, and it is that deciding map. That's the big thing.
And in this round, at least, they're not going to have the economy to get a buy-up. So you're going to be looking at NIP being 13-9 ahead, more than likely. Four-round lead. They did have similar scenarios on Cobblestone.
at least the full losing bonus is built up for Godsend, so they can invest something into this round. They're going to all spend, you know, anywhere between $15 and $2,000. Mm-hmm. Because with the full losing bonus building up, no matter what happens next round, they're going to be able to have their AKs. They'll be able to have an AWP if they want it. Looks like Twist is actually going to be the one saving for that. Oh, as I say that, he just buys out just to mess with me.
Get trolled.
So half investment from Godsend into this round. See if they can do something. See if they can... I mean, the economy, the big thing, the good thing for Godsend is the economy for NIP isn't that strong. They've had a couple rounds where they've got some decent amount of kills, so there's not too much of a bank built up. NIP can sustain, you know, maybe one round loss, but after that, Godsend has the opportunity, if they can string two rounds together, to really close the gap a little bit just by going up against Pistols, but they have to win those two rounds, and it has to be soon. They're running out of time to make this play.
Well, here we go again. Back into the server, back into live. Godsend. With their mixed match of weaponry, with their Kevlars and their upgraded pistols looking to do it. Pitts actually go for a peek. If he misses this shot, he could be a dead man, and that could afford the B push to come in. But he's landed it, and there's Get Right as well. Two, three kills. He's looking for a fourth. He runs out of bullets. But single-handedly locking down the B side. I thought it was going to be all on Pitt. What I didn't factor in is the Get Right.
One player's made it out, though, and that's Kronax. He gets one kill. There's Pitt, though, and he's going to respond with the last two. But three kills for Godsend, that is going to keep this money low. It's going to force some drops, force some buy-ups. So there are going to be a couple players with very low money on the NIP side. A little bit of a underrated play out of Pit there when he's pushing with Get Right. As soon as he misses that first shot, as soon as they realize the force they're against, he just bails out.
Just gets the hell out.
Very, very smart play. And you just say, all right, Get Right, sorry, do what you can. I'm out of here. Stay alive. Wait for the teammates to come. Oh, nice pick from Twist, though. He gets the opening kill onto Forest. That's going to force back some of this aggression out of NIP. Mid control goes in the way of Godsend, except for Pitt. He stays on catwalk. This young player has really come alive here for NIP.
He certainly has had quite a quiet game against VP, but he's landed some massive, massive frags, bringing us back to a 4v4. Godsend do have mid control. But again, now Freiburg steps up for the Shadows of Forest. He's typically the connection control. Player in Palace is going to be Twist. He's going to be trying to peek out with that AWP, see if he can get a pick. But for the time being, NIP are just waiting again.
They trust a lot at Get Right at the moment. He's got catwalk to worry about. He's got the B tunnels to worry about. He's alone at this B bomb site. With three members, this is it's a great read from NIP. Freiburg exists and Pit all ready to deal with any kind of A hit that comes into play. There's the first one though. Twist wins that battle. See you later, exists. Freiburg now towards connector. He gets dropped as well.
Oh, that no scope could be everything to Godsend. 40 seconds left, 2-1-2. HP advantage firmly going in the favor of NIP, but Twist still has that AWP. And now it's all that remains. Pitt's missed his chance. Is he going to get punished for that miss? Twist now out in the open. 20 seconds left. Flashbang onto CT side. Get Right still in connector. Very nearly gets picked off from Twist. He's just a couple millimeters away. Twist is going to try and fake out. In fact, actually holds down onto the site. Get Right's doing damage, picks him off through the box. And there's only a certain amount of places that Twist could have been in that situation. So smart play from Get Right. NIP will take a 14th round.
You could see though, Twist had to go on the hunt there with the clock dwindling down and the bomb in his hands. He had to try and find one of those two players. He had him isolated just on positioning in one-on-one situations, but can't land the shot. And then his only hope from there is to get the bomb planted behind that smoke before it fades. So NIP outlasts them. Twist made it possible, but Get Right on the rotation, gets there just in time.
He was so close to hitting Get Right in connector as well. And that could have been the difference maker. But as it stands now, a 5-round lead has opened up for NIP. Will be another buy for Godsend. That tactical timeout hasn't seemingly worked too well for Godsend so far. Here comes the push onto short. And Forrest is going to get the better of that confrontation. It's actually Pitt now that's going to be holding onto connector. Decides against it. You got the first pick. Don't give anything away.
Still a very passive defense from NIP with that pick. Just backing up into their sights, letting Pitt get the information or get the long-range shots of that AWP. Exists playing very passively, but it's all on Godsend. Trying to boost up to get a pick on catwalk. Trying to find anyone. Oh, and that smoke.
Whoops. That's pretty crucial as well, actually.
Yeah, that's a big mistake at this point in the match.
So Twist is going to try and find something now, and actually it's going to be Freiburg who's got to be very careful not to expose himself too much. There's the op though. Twist can't find the shot, and still this boost has not been fruitful. It has given them absolutely nothing. Although Forrest, oh, just as they get down, that's heartbreaking. Forrest with the dagger, and it's down to a 1-on-5. Falf, he's just gonna run up one flashbang out, and he's just gonna see what he can get, and it's absolutely nothing. NIP on the verge of making it to the grand finals.
6 match points. Timing was a very real threat for Godsent. As you say though, they held on to that boost for a long time. It just gave them absolutely nothing in the end, and here we go. As soon as they turn their backs, Forrest is there, double headshot.
Even if they were stacked up, that might have been a slaughter for Forrest because they were peering up a catwalk. But either way, all that's left for Godsent to do this last round, they have to make it work with 3 Tech Nines, and they've given up map control. Switch tactics completely. Now they're just going to go for a standard execute onto this A bomb site. Schneider to lurk and mid. But here it is.
Molly thrown down. That's going to stop. Initial charge actually filters off a couple plays. Oh my goodness. Godsent have actually got themselves 2 kills. Freiburg is doing what he can. There's 2 kills for him. 2v3. Get right and pit. AK, in fact, pardon me, an M4 and AWP respectively for the 2 remaining ninjas. Just the 1 AK in play and has been picked off. Get right now. With 21 health, finds himself in a sketchy position. Player on Tetris, he's spotted. Going to be flashing himself out of this one. Smoke is down as well, gets picked off from the cross from Schneider. Godsent has saved 1 of those 6 match points.
5 more to go and $11,000 on Pit the burn through. He's going to go right back to the AWP, and that just about does it. He also had to drop an M4 over to a teammate. So if Godsent can win this round, they may have done it. They may have finally broken the economy, and that'll allow them to close the gap a little bit more. Molotov usage on that execute was superb. On top of Balcony to force that player away, they bust up any stack, any crossfires that NIP had, and Kronax aggressively in B-Halls. He's going to get challenged by the AWP of Pit eventually.
Yeah, Pit's going to have a quick peek in a second. Just hiding around the corner. Is Pronax. If he bites his time and waits here, he will definitely get rewarded. But Pin actually just throwing the smoke, a small gap, and pounces on top of it. Cat-like reactions.
Oh, that is nasty. What a jerk. That angle in the smoke, so cruel. Boost up from Palf, though, and Twist once again. This has been very effective, this AWP in Palace.
Him and Lecro really have been the 2 star players, I'd say, today for Godsent. Molotov into Shadow, forces out the player. Forrest, meanwhile, connector again, gets the bomb dropped. That's hilarious. That's just absolutely brutal for Godsent. 2v1, Palf. Can he save the semi-finals? He's being tanked up from short, picked off through the wooden panels. And Getright will secure the semi-finals for NIP. They go through to the finals to face off against Na'Vi.
Starts it off with that incredible Pisteron, and he ends it with that last kill. So fitting for Getright. But NIP, surely they were tested in this series. Godsent hit a level we didn't think they would. They brought NIP to the brink here on those first 2 maps.
Crowd very pleased, very appreciative of that fantastic match. And you know what, I think Godsent can hold themselves high here. They can have their chins up.
Absolutely.
And realize we came into this not really expecting too much. We went to the semifinals and very nearly progressed through.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, the players, the performance at Electro in this series was absolutely insane. They've got a lot of promising things going on in the future, but at least for the moment, NIP still reigns supreme. Taught them a few lessons here and there. I mean, Mirage, just you could, that ability for NIP to be so down in the first half, they're getting just battered. It was, what, 8-2 at one point, and then they make this comeback right at the end, which gives them enough of an opportunity into the second half. So just a beautiful performance from NIP to be able to come back in that.
Okay, well, we do have an interview on the stage. Smix is with Getright, so take it away.
Congratulations to NIP as they move on to the grand finals. Yeah. get right. I spoke with Freiburg yesterday after your guys' win, and he said how much it means to make it to the top four, be in the semifinals after, you know, just a long period of time of reevaluation, revamping the team. And now you guys have made it to the grand finals here in Malmö, Sweden. What does this all mean to you so far?
It means the world to me, since everyone has always been giving us criticism for a long time, and especially to one of two, thanks man, to Exist and Fiverr for, you know, giving them shit online and so on. So it means the world for me too that we can prove everyone wrong, especially since everyone has been saying that we are dying space, like species or something like that. So it's a nice thing to be in the final. We just want to be playing the final and make it to another good show.
Now, this semifinal series was so action-packed. It felt like it went back and forth a lot with the momentum swinging both of your teams' ways. What do you think were the crucial things that NIP did that finally got the win in your favor?
The crowd.
Fair enough. The crowd here in Malmö Arena has been absolutely amazing. And as I was watching this series, I was wondering, did you get any flashbacks to DreamHack Winter 2013 as Pronex and Schneider, that it was right when Pronex had just joined Fnatic and they were sort of the underdogs and you faced them at the finals there and they took you guys down 2-1 and for a moment there, it looks like it would be a sort of a repeat of that incident.
Don't talk about the memory, please.
All right, bad memories. Now, moving forward, obviously, we saw that you guys beat a lot of tough opponents to get here. You beat VP, Astralis, and now you just beat Godsend. And coming up next is going to be your hardest opponent of the tournament so far. It'll be Na'Vi. Now, obviously, you're showing a much more revamped NIP, but what are your thoughts on this upcoming match?
We just want to win the final and giving everything, and we want to do it for our fans that's been supporting us since forever, you know, so that's our only goal. And if now I've been saying it to everyone who's been saying me, like, before this game, like, yeah, you're gonna meet Na'Vi in the final. I'm like, how can you even say that? Godsend is a really good team, and I've been saying it before to, like, friends and so on, and been, like, jinxing myself, like, yeah, we're gonna go to the final, then all of a sudden I lose against X team, Y team, or whatever it is in tournament. So it's been one step at a time, and now we're in the final, and we have one goal left, and it's to win the final.
All right, then. Well, congratulations again to Get Right and NIP. They will be facing Na'Vi in the grand finals.
I can confidently.
Indeed, they will. I'm Alex Machine Richardson.
And you know the score, and we know the score.
Indeed. I mean, maybe I should start my segment so I can actually make sure. Hey, the Score Esports application, check it out right now. It's available for news, stats, all of that. Look at it right there. Go check it out. You can do that. And there you go. Jobs are good. And now, Duncan.
Yeah.
Why have you got a big smirk on your face? NIP have done it and will be in the grand finals versus Na'Vi. I just want to I like to let you get it out early so we can actually do some analysis.
I mean, on the desk, it was 2-1, and my prediction was 2-1. And their prediction was 2-0 because they thought I'm a zero, but actually I'm one. I am the one. So 2-1.
Okay.
I win.
Right,
I was the only one who got ahead.
Time's up.
2-1.
Smug mode off. Okay. We are going to do some proper analysis after we get some quick emotions from Parler, who's standing by. He's grabbed the nearest player he could find as NIP advanced to the grand finals.
Are going to try to be quite quick because Threat and the guys need to eat and recharge, which they definitely deserve after that game. What are your initial thoughts after that match?
I was really scared beginning on the first map. They had a 6-0 lead, and when we've been practicing Kabul, we've been just stomping everyone on our T side. I think Pronax had a really good read on us on almost every single map, so yeah, it was a really scary series.
Talking about recharging, you guys, after a series like that, there's been talk, you know, between all of us backstage that it's so difficult to be as prepared as you can be for the upcoming match because your energy levels must be going down. You must already feel like you've been through an absolutely epic war.
Yeah, I mean, 3 maps overtime on the second map, the last map, it was 16-9, but it was a really tight map anyway, so we're really tired now, but hopefully if we get some food, maybe some energy drinks, I'm definitely going to have a cup of coffee. I think we're going to play well in the final as well.
Okay, and so you said you picked Cobble because you guys have been smashing everyone on it in practice. When it came to in practice in real life, in a real on a real high level, did it work out exactly how you thought it would? Because it was it ended up being quite close, 16-14, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, as usual, Peronax has all these sneaky rounds. Beginning on the pistol round, he has had a trap set for us in mid with a crossfire, which is a very risky move, but we just ran into the trap and yeah, just lost the pistol after that. It felt like he had a good read on us all the first weapon rounds. I think they were up 6-0 at one point. After that, we had a little chat and we said, okay, obviously Peronax knows what we're doing, and we just tried to change our play style, and we got at least 7 rounds at half.
When you have players on your team that are playing players on other teams that they've been, you know, competing against for so long, especially someone like Peronax, does it feel not physical, but you can tell that you're battling another brain almost, and that there's this kind of clash of, you know, head and skill?
Yeah, definitely. Even back in 1.6, I played him so much, and that's one of the main reasons why we dislike playing Swedish teams, because when you know each other's playstyle so well, it almost become this kind of rock, paper, scissor type of game.
Yeah, well, last thing, because I do want to let you go and recharge and eat and stuff. Na'Vi, Grand Final. Firstly, how does it feel for you to be in this Grand Final? And then secondly, what do you think about Na'Vi, the chances, etc.?
It's going to be maybe the best experience in my Counter-Strike career, being able to play in front of a Swedish audience like this. It's going to be absolutely awesome. But the final itself is going to be really, really tough. We struggled a lot with Na'Vi in the past. We had a really close game versus them in Katowice. So it's going to be very, very tough, but hopefully we can beat them.
Okay, Threat, well, we will see. Best of luck. You are free to go and eat now and recoup with the team. Get ready for this final matchup. The crowd were behind you in that last one, and I'm sure they will do the same in the final against Na'Vi.
Awesome stuff there. Great question as well about the whole idea of kind of Peronax and Threat playing chess, that whole kind of battle of the brains is something that definitely I'm sure can be quite exciting for that coach to in-game leader dynamic. And we saw a whole lot from Peronax's side, not quite enough yet to convert it into victory. Now Ninjas are going to be preparing for a huge game versus Na'Vi, but we're going to try and kind of understand, especially specifically Mirage, what we experienced there. Robin, we haven't even heard from you just yet. Mirage, what were we seeing that kind of seemed to fall flat from Godsent? They tried so much.
Yeah, I mean, NIP had a great approach from the get-go, and I think Mirage, going third maps in, and I think NIP, it's one of their strongest maps. They could have even possibly picked it as their first map. Instead, they decided to let it go, and they're up on a third map, and when you have a game this close and you have Mirage as third, you're going to be happy about that. But I think Threat there at our, you know, a nice point to make, where it's like it's a domestic lineup or a domestic matchup, and I'm sure these guys have practiced against each other quite some time. But yeah, overall, I think just the regular approach that they had, even on the CT side, or on their T side, that they knew that Godsend would be pushing, and they were somewhat prepared for it this time. Only getting six rounds, that massive pistol round by Getright saved them a little bit. Winning both pistols actually also saved them. So.
I think we should just highlight how close Godsent were to it, right? Like that get right pistol. There are a few pinpoint moments where Godsent saw it slip away. Actually, Yanko, you look like you've got an answer to that.
I mean, the Getter did have that crazy pistol round, but NIP just proceeded to lose the second round, and it didn't mean as much because Lecro had a couple of crazy rounds with the Deagle. I mean, it's not even we were praising NIP for their anti-force by play, but there's nothing you can do when a player just takes a quick peek and one-shots you with the Deagle. You know, there's nothing just to do it. It's been a great individual performance, and NIP were down 9-2 actually in that half, and it looked pretty grim from them. And then they win that quasi-buy round where Forest somehow manages to sneak into the B bombs. And for me, I think that was the most crucial round in the whole game that allowed NIP after that to come back into the first half and gave them some, you know, room for mistakes for the second half potentially even.
I think in this third map, we really saw like who both the teams are right now. So, okay, Godsense looked good on all these T sides. Well, they were in position to win the whole game on T side. If they just execute there, the game is theirs. They're going into the final. Meanwhile, NIP had made most of the other maps of the tournament. They'd won on the T side. But if you remember, all these third maps they've had in these other series, it's like clutch individual plays on CT side that win them the big rounds. And this time it was Get Right. It was the original star who really came up huge. Had a couple of rounds that really just like cut Godsent down immediately where they were standing, and you saw it wasn't that Godsent like floundered and failed or whatever. They'd already done so well to get to this point in the game. It's just at that point in time, it's like elevation from some of the NiP players just pushed them over the finish line.
And I guess, yeah, that's something that is that kind of magic that's hard to kind of quantify and understand necessarily where it comes from, but it does seem to always be present, and NIP do find themselves in a grand final. Now, for specific plays, let's talk about that, Janko. Have you got anything for us to break down?
Yes. All actually, right. The round that I just mentioned, the round,
macro?
Yeah, the 12th round of the first half, when NIP was down 9-2, and when they had this quasi-buy round, and it was a really an unfortunate timing, so to speak, from the Godsent guys. Maybe small miscommunication as well, because as you can see initially, they have three players towards B. They're maybe expecting a fast B split or something like that, and we can now play the beginning of the clip. So NIP has flashes for Forest. The goal is to draw attention towards the B bomb site. And you can see here, we can stop it here real quick, just maybe a couple of seconds more, 1 second after. Yeah, I can see how Schneider is just turning away to go towards Kitchen, and Lekro is still watching this line towards the B bomb site. And Forest goes for an unconventional jump through the smoke and manages to kill Lekro in the back. There's even, I think it's Pronex who is towards the short area, so now we can keep on rolling the clip. You can see that Forest now is buying time, and on the minimap, you can see Twist and Schneider, actually the other player from B, and Twist, who is in window room, he's forced now to move, to help towards the B bombsite, because they don't know if there are more players behind Forest here yet. Pronex is focused on him in that position. And actually the strat here from NIP, as it seems to me, is they also smoked the window. So the plan is to draw attention towards the B bombsite so that then they can boost a player into the smoke and surprise the player who is rotating towards B, maybe kill him in the back, and then create room for the bomb, which was left in B. So now I'm not sure if maybe they wanted to go A, or Freiburg is supposed to go back and maybe go for a double fake and delayed B. But now we can play it out to see how it actually works. So it works perfectly for NIP because of that. They get good timing here, a bit lucky also onto Twist, who pulled out an aid. Then also on the A bomb site, I think it was Pau, yes, who had some problems with Getright, and a bit of an unfortunate circumstance, but also NIP seizing the moment, so to speak, being able to execute this quasi-buy pretty well. And you can tell, before this round, Godsent won 5 rounds in a row, and by losing this one round, they had to go on an eco, which then allowed NIP to win the last 4 rounds and make it into a 9-6 half, where, if you think about it, Godsent should have, if they won this round, they would have probably gotten at least 11 rounds. So it's been a really important round for NIP, and it probably gave them some momentum coming into the second half as well.
Awesome stuff from Janko, as always. I mean, it does just seem like it helps us to get our head around the intricacies that you can't see, like in the flash of an eye. Of course, not everyone can see in the flash of an eye, and then we see just the power of one player, a player like Forest, a player like Getright. These are the players that we're going to be highlighting from NIP who did deliver and were responsible for NIP in the end, wrapping up Mirage and that best of three. But let's turn quickly to Godsent. As we are waving goodbye to the new Swedish roster, what have we just seen? What do we have to look forward to for this roster? Is this a flash in the pan? Will Godsent proceed to now have, to fall off, and we'll be wondering where on earth they went? Or have we really seen the start of something quite special for them in the coming months at CSGO?
In terms of individual performances, I thought it was very positive. Like, for example, okay, we knew Twist was a good player anyway. We know Pronx is a good in-game leader. Schneider's been a solid player, so that's all fit the bill. I think the big breakout's obviously been Lekra. I mean, he was actually pretty good throughout the whole series. He seemed to keep up with a pace with the other good players. Yeah. That's all good in terms of individual play.
And this is actually a highlight of him.
Sure. The big concern I have for this team in terms of why it might be a bit of a flash in the pan, they might fall down in the next few events, is when I look at it, I think their map pool's a little bit shallow. I don't think they really have that many strengths in maps where they're a surefire win. So I think as teams figure out how to pick and ban against them and play them on those key maps, that'll degrade the quality a little bit. And then there's also the factor that in future tournaments, I mean, there's going to be even more really, really hard teams to have to play against. So you look at the teams they beat here. Yeah, they beat some good teams like CLG, Mouseworth. These are solid teams, but they didn't actually get any wins over the big, big teams. So I think they've still got a lot to prove if they want to be considered like a top 5, top 8 type team, because normally you have to be able to get upsets over the big teams to get into that sort of a ranking. You know, just being solid, just being above the tier 2 isn't quite enough. But in that sense, I think they have established themselves as like a new prospect, certainly.
Absolutely. Well, I mean, so you'd put them in the same category as your Tempo Storms and
sure. I think that's like a good analogy because Tempo Storm, I mean, we saw they actually failed at this tournament. They didn't make it out. The Katowice tournament was brilliant. Didn't make it out of the qualifiers. So it's been up and down with them. We know if they play really well, yeah, they can beat these better teams. Mm. So I think they're in that sort of a realm here. But just like Tempo Storm, we have to see it a few more tournaments before we can give them legitimacy.
In agreement there, Yanko?
Definitely. And I think their performance has been pretty impressive for their first showing here. And it's not just a first international tournament. It's also that even in online play, they haven't been meeting these teams, even the teams around the top 10, like CLG and Mouse. And now they've been able to beat those teams on LAN, have an extremely good game against NIP, and definitely show that they have potential and that with time and practice, they have more to show for sure.
Awesome stuff. Just closing stuff from you, Robin. NIP, they're going up against Navi. They actually look like they were having trips and stumbles versus Godsent. It could be not boding too well for the Swedes in the grand final.
Yeah, I mean, one thing Paula touched upon there is that they only have, what, like 30, 45, an hour break coming into versus
we're giving
Navi.
We're giving them a full hour. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. And Navi's been, I mean, looking super strong this tournament. One of the best teams in the world. For NIP, it's going to be extremely hard here for them. And I really hope that they have a game plan.
And I mean, we are going to be talking all about that game and more after our break. But as I already hinted at already, it's not fair to throw NIP straight back into their game. We're going to let them catch their breath, relax, and set their minds at ease before they prepare themselves for their grand final. It will be versus Navi, a fully, fully informed Navi. They've already looked rather fierce in this tournament. Then NIP, after a couple of initial problems over on Cobble, they did manage to pick up the first map victory, then move swiftly into Train, where Godsent did flex their muscles and show that it truly is one of their best maps. Now, NIP are in the grand finals versus Navi, and we've learned great stuff about Godsent. It's been a pleasure, and we'll be back with your grand finals of DreamHack Masters Malmo after this.